Hello, you gorgeous people. This is Chris from Akombu, and I'm here out in gorgeous Hawaii, where Qualcomm is holding its annual Snapdragon Summit. They've officially launched the Snapdragon 855 chipset in a dark hall just 20 feet over that way. The latest flagship Snapdragon chipset, which you'll find in basically all of the big smartphones of 2019. They gave a very brief overview of some of the biggest features of the new Snapdragon 855, which I'll just cover now. I'll be just as brief because that Hawaii sun is absolutely baking my fair northern skin. So first up, as you would expect, the Snapdragon 855 boasts a bit of a performance boost compared with last year's Snapdragon 845. Qualcomm reckons you'll get 3 times a performance improvement compared with last year's chipset, and you'll also get, impressively, a 2 times performance improvement on recently announced rivals. They did basically say that it'll be 2 times better than the Huawei Kirin 980 and Apple's A12 as well. They didn't mention them by name, but they did say 7-nanometer chipsets launched just a couple of months ago by a couple of big competitors, pretty much. The Snapdragon 855 will also include the 4th generation version of Qualcomm's AI engine. Again, there's no real details behind this yet, but you can bet your buttocks that it'll be dedicated to a wide range of features such as smart scene recognition, voice recognition, and loads of other clever stuff like that. All of which will hopefully happen on the chip itself, so your phone doesn't have to rely on a stable web connection for any of it. But will the Snapdragon 855 actually come packing a dedicated neural processing unit, just like Huawei's Kirin 980? Well, there's been no specific details on that, but hopefully we'll find out in the next day or two. The Snapdragon 855 also boasts the world's first computer vision ISP. Computer vision has actually been added into that image signaling processor to help with scene recognition, in addition to the AI smarts. So basically, you can expect your smartphone's camera to choose the correct settings for any shot in no time at all. Qualcomm has also produced a 3D sonic sensor, which is designed to sit underneath the smartphone display and accurately recognize any fingerprint that touches it. This can actually capture a full 3D image of your fingerprints, ridges, and pores for impressive authentication, rather than a simple 2D image like most rivals. And it can even take things like greasy prints and grime into account as well. Mobile gaming is, of course, huge as we go into 2019. And that's why Qualcomm has announced the dramatically titled Elite Gaming Smarts, which is packed into the Snapdragon 855 to fine-tune the gaming experience in every area. So basically what you can expect is cinematic graphics and audio, as well as solid performance and no compromise to battery life. Again, that is basically all that they said. We haven't got any specific details on what this gaming elite stuff will actually do. Again, that's basically all the details they revealed. We haven't got any specifics on what elite gaming actually involves. But we'll be speaking with Qualcomm representatives over the next couple of days of the summit to really dive in and get some more information for you. And of course, there is full 5G support with the Snapdragon 855, as you kind of expect from Qualcomm, who has been banging on in a good way about 5G for quite a few years now. The first proper 5G consumer networks are set to be rolled out in 2019, including across 12 cities in the UK, courtesy of EE. And Samsung, of course, also came on stage to announce that yes, they will be launching one of the first 5G-ready phones in 2019. So that'll be the Galaxy S10 then. Motorola's Moto Z3 will also support 5G, courtesy of a special Moto mod that will be thrown out into stores next year. And of course, Qualcomm is in talks with all of the big OEMs, including the likes of Huawei, OnePlus, and Sony. So you can expect all of these devices to come packing Snapdragon 855 chipsets in 2019 with a bit of 5G smarts for bonus. I'm now being eaten alive by the local wildlife, and the back of my head has basically started to peel away, so I'm going to leave it right there. But leave any comments down below on what you're hoping for on the Snapdragon 855. If you've got any specific questions about the 855 chipset as well, we will be speaking with Qualcomm, as I say, over the next couple of days of the summit. And my God, there's a lot of noise going on here. Thanks for watching, anyone. Cheers, bye.